top there. You got accumulation on top and accumulation left and right. You see how it's accumulating quite a bit here. But at least we got a flow now. Before we didn't have a flow. It's too bad. It's flowing so high. Yeah, we lose it right there. But let's take it all the way out to the septic tank and then we'll turn off the water. Alright, see? Look at the big chunk on the top there. I'm surprised anything gets by there. I just barely make it. We hit it with the camera, but then we slide under. Alright, there's the surface coming in left and right. Alright, there's the PVC at the septic tank. There might be a little clean out right there, actually. See it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, let me go locate that. That way you can dig it up for maintenance in the future. Alright, at this point we're going to turn off the water and we'll TV it one more time coming back and see what it looks like. Okay, we've got that clean out located. Now we'll go ahead and pull it back one more time. The water stopped flowing. We'll see if we're holding water. And we'll see the condition of the pipe. So right there, it's really closed down. It almost looks like a triangle or a hexagon or something. The way there's so many sides that are... See, look at that. The top, left and right. It's got so much accumulation and everything catches. We've got all the sludge out. Do you want to see this, sir?
Yeah, I sure do.
All right. Let me go back down to the septic tank. All right. So there's the PVC pipe and the septic tank's down there. So as we're coming back, there's a transition into the cast iron pipe. That's it. That's better, yeah. There's a transition to the cast iron pipe. All right. And you can see how it's not round. It's got accumulation mostly on the top and the sides. All this stuff here, this bumpy stuff, that's accumulation. That should be round, just like you've seen in the past. And of course, you know, and it gets worse. See how bad it gets there?
Yeah.
This big lump, left and right, on the top?
Yeah.
Those big lumps are restricting your flow, and you got more lumps there. Yeah, there's a lot of lumps. That's a combination of grease and just corrosion of the pipe. All right, see, grease flows, so it goes to the top, and corrosion happens all the way around over time. You can see it's all tuberculated, you know, not so much chewed up. And if the integrity of the pipe wall is good, you just need to get rid of all that.
Yeah.
All right. So as we come back, yeah, there's one point here where we can see, look at it here, how it's growing. It's all these lumps growing down.
Yeah.
And there was one point back here where I couldn't hardly get the camera to go through. Now there's a little bit of sludge on the bottom that accumulates over time because it's not flowing good.
Is that hard and stony or is it sludge?
Usually when it adheres to the top it's hard. Okay, the slush lays on the bottom.
It looks like a straight shot.
And it's a straight shot for about 50 feet and then there's 10 feet to come over and this turn comes over to this bathroom. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right. Yeah. Yeah. There's quite a bit there. It gets better as we come back. But see how it just got restricted right there?
Yeah.
Now you got two openings, one on the left and one on the right. That's probably looks like maybe a double bathroom or something. Back-to-back bathrooms. Which fitting?
The double
wash?
Yeah. One there?
Yeah, see there's one on the left and one on the right.
When he was down one stack?
He was coming up the other. Yeah, it's across, it goes straight across. So he's going down that stack. Instead of going down line, it was going across and coming up the other. It's a common problem. And then, unfortunately, they They should stagger those instead of running cross T's like that. Yeah. All right, see, look at that big chunk. I almost couldn't get past that.
Yeah.
On the top.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah.
You know, well, why is that? Well, the whole line needs to be cleaned, you know, and we can get in there with a... I'll show you, I got a hole saw on my jetter that goes through and restores a lot of the... of the pipe. You know, you hate to go too hard because you don't want to break the pipe, but you... You know, on this a 4-inch pipe, I'd probably use my 3-inch cutter and see how it does. And if it goes in... That's 4-inch right there. It's closed down to probably 2.5. Two and a half, yeah. Yeah, especially down at the end. This here might be closer to 3. See, you got more here. You see, and the... if you get that jetted, you eliminate a lot of that. You're not going to eliminate it at all. But a lot of the stuff that's really protruding, you'll eliminate. It'll still look rough, but it'll be, instead of, you know, a half inch accumulation, it'll be an eighth of an inch. It'll still look rough, but it'll, at least it won't be protruding into the pipe as much.
Yeah. Or snagging things.
And snagging things, right.
Yeah, that's
see here? Now here you got shoulders. See, you got a shoulder on the left and a shoulder on the right on the side of the pipe. And you got tuberculation on the top. So that restricts the flow as well. And I'll be making a DVD of this, and I'll send it to Dirk. And if he wants, I'll send you a copy.
That'd be good.
Yeah, that way you'll have it on record. If you just you can decide what to do with it at that point. But initially, all we had was water here when we first went in. We couldn't get, you couldn't see anything. It was all full of water. So all that slush and blockage down line was restricting the flow, and that's, of course, that causes backups. And now that we were able to flush all that out by running all the water and running the camera down there 2-3 times, we can actually see what's going on here and why you're having those problems. But even back here, we're back to 16 feet from 60. Look at that big shoulder on the left and on the right. It's just a lot of accumulation that you can get rid of a lot of that. I work with Dirk. I have a jetter, yeah, and he would dig it up there at the septic tank, and that way we can go in. Now see here, there's a turn. We just turned back on a 45. The pipe continues straight that way, and we're coming back on an angle to this toilet. Yeah, 9 feet back.
All right.
That's the tuberculation. Yes. Yeah. It's not quite so bad here. See, we're in a 3-inch pipe now.
Yeah.
At the Y, it transitioned into 4-inch.
Yeah.
Right. So in 3-inch, we still got the same, it appears, same diameter as we had there in the 4. So it's not as bad, right. No. It doesn't, right. And here we're back at the toilet riser. And there's this. Okay, that completes the inspection of that line. And I really would recommend that you get it jetted. That would remove a lot of that. You just have to be careful, whoever does the jetting, that they don't break the pipe.
Yeah.
The important thing is to go in, try to remove as much of that corrosion as possible, to open it up,
right,
and restore flow so that you can use it for a while.